development scenario in the country. The time is very short, just 5 minutes, so I will skip through. In fact, we had a wonderful information passed on by my predecessor here. So a lot of the information that I have here is not required to be repeated. I'll straightway jump to three things that I want to talk about in this keynote address. We are, all of us, aware of the magnitude of the problem that we face. We are actually staring into demographic nightmare, not a dividend, really. We do not handle our young people that we have, lots and lots of them, with the average age of the country being just 27 years. So we don't handle this, we don't skill our people, we will have a huge problem. This has been realized by the government, by the external agencies, the US, the World Bank, and our own government here, that unless we do something about skilling our people, we are going to land in a problem. The UGC project, I come straight back to the role of the skills universities. The government has taken a lot of initiative at skilling at the low level, 3 months, 6 months, 1 year programs. That's not going to solve the problem completely. The present skill development programs are not very inspirational. No parent wants to send his child to either a ITI or a polytechnic. They are considered below par. Everybody wants a university degree, so we've got to do something about that. The UGC thought about it some time ago. In 2013, they floated a Bachelor of Vocation program. The slide that we see here is the UGC floated BWOC program with multiple exit and multiple entry. A very good proposal. A lot of universities have started offering this program. But it is not fully addressed. These programs are offered by normal universities with normal infrastructure. So it is just an add-on to the normal degrees that we do. We need to do something much, much more than that. We need to create skills universities. One initiative taken by one Dr. Rajendra Kumar Joshi, who was originally from Rajasthan and now settled in Switzerland, he spent his whole life there. Switzerland is one of the best countries which has benefited from skill development. They have a dual system of skill development. Children after 9th standard go to skill schools. They weekends they work, study in the school, and during the week they work in the industry as a part of that learning. And with that diploma in 3 or 4 years after 9th standard, they go to the industry and they can rise with that diploma to the highest position in the industry. That doesn't happen in India. We don't promote a turner or a miller or a welder or a fitter to managerial positions, in spite of all the skill expertise he may have. So that is not going to change. I think the industry is geared up, and we will focus on hiring a clerk in our government office. We need graduation. Of course, for all officers, for the officer position, we need graduation. Industry also follows that. So we want to have skills programs which eventually lead to graduation and post-graduation, so that everybody's aspirations are met. So the skills universities are going to meet that.